With the Stryker A1 initial maneuver short-range air defense, shortly IM-SHORAD, the USA is returning to operating the self-propelled anti-aircraft guns. The change of the modern combat environment forces the Western armies to be reorganized. This self-propelled anti-aircraft gun, shortly SPAAG, has very different features from previous classical ones. Analyzing it could give us important clues to understand the future combat areas. As the weapon detective, we are investigating the IM-SHORAD, a versatile SPAAG. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel before we start, and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. To be notified of our new video, please click the bell button. Also, you can now click the join button to support our channel. The IM-SHORAD is different from the classical SPAAGs. It is designed to answer various types of modern threats in combat areas. As we mentioned in our Korkut video, the NATO armies have needed new SPAAGs for some time. But there is an important difference. While Turkey chose a conventional design, the USA is offering an innovative one. Let's take a brief look at the historical background of the process, which paved the way for the development of the IM-SHORAD. For a long time, the US armed forces had not invested much in the SPAAGs compared to the Eastern Bloc. The reason was simple. The USA has never fought without air superiority since the Second World War. Of course, the USA had developed some successful SPAAGs like the M163 and some unsuccessful ones like the M247. But ground-based air defense has never been a priority. The last operational SPAAG of the US Army was the M6 Linebacker. This M2 Bradley-based vehicle became operational in 1998, and after just 7 years, it was retired. Also, the US Marine Corps had the SPAAG version of the LAW. Yet, due to lack of air threats, this vehicle, called LAW AD, was retired too. But a new threat has arisen. Especially in the Middle East, many terrorist and guerrilla groups began to use drones as a weapon. Besides, these groups can now reach the rockets and mortars easily, and they can conduct attacks from long distances. Also, the loitering munitions have proven their effectiveness in the last few years. The man-portable and pedestal-mounted Stingers of the US Army cannot deal with threats. Besides, the Avenger does not provide ballistic protection for the crew. So, in 2017, the US Army demanded the development of a self-propelled new air defense system which could cope with the drones, mortar shells, rockets, and loitering munitions, as well as conventional air threats such as aircraft and helicopters. As a simple solution, BAE Systems offered an updated version of the M6 Linebacker in the same year. But now, the US Army wanted a wheeled vehicle. So in 2017, General Dynamics and Boeing offered the Stryker Mobile SHORAD Launcher, shortly Stryker MSL. This SPAAG is a highly modified variant of the Stryker Wheeled Armored Vehicle. It was equipped with a surface launch variant of the Sidewinder Air Defense Missiles, AGM-114L Hellfire Anti-Tank Missiles, and a 30mm M230 gun. Thanks to the variety of its weaponry, the Stryker MSL could fight against many different types of threats. The concept was okay, but the vehicle didn't satisfy the US Army. The Stryker MSL was a highly modified design. The US Army wanted a simpler solution. So, the US Army initiated the IM-SHORAD program in February 2018 and ordered a total of 9 prototype vehicles 7 months later. General Dynamics equipped its Stryker vehicle with Moog's reconfigurable integrated weapons platform turret system, which is more compact and modular. Also, this turret was providing increased protection for the crew. The Italian Leonardo DRS company was responsible for the development of the mission equipment package of the IM-SHORAD. In October 2019, the US Army was handed over the first prototype. In the same year, the IM-SHORAD was unveiled at the AUSA 2019. The US Army plans to have up to 144 SPAAGs. Actually, the IM-SHORAD is not quite an SPAAG. The main armament of these vehicles is their guns. However, the gun on the IM-SHORAD is considered a secondary armament. it relies on its missiles. The IM-SHORAD provides air defense against low-flying aircraft and helicopters. It is also effective against the Group 3 unmanned aerial vehicles, which fly at an altitude of over 4,500 meters, in other words 15,000 feet, with a speed of 460 kilometers per hour. Thanks to its 30mm gun, the IM-SHORAD can shoot down miniature and mini unmanned aerial vehicles at closer ranges with direct fire. The SPAAG also offers protection against artillery and mortar shells, as well as rockets and cruise missiles. As you know, the SPAAGs are also excellent ground fire support vehicles. Thanks to its Hellfire missiles, the IM-SHORAD takes this capability to the next level, but it is not an armored anti-tank vehicle. The specifications of the IM-SHORAD is not officially published yet, but if you consider that the Hellfire missile weighs 50 kilograms, there should be one or two loaders besides the commander, gunner, and driver. To have an idea, we can also mention the dimensions of a standard Stryker A1, which is 7 meters long, 2.72 meters wide, and 2.64 meters high. The suspension of the vehicle can deal with a weight of around 28 tons, so IM-SHORAD could not be heavier. It is equipped with a 450 horsepower Caterpillar C9 engine. We estimate that the road speed is about 100 kilometers per hour, and the range is over 500 kilometers. The vehicle has one 30mm XM914 Bushmaster chain gun and one 7.62mm M240 coaxial machine gun, as well as the AGM-114L Longbow Hellfire and Stinger missiles. The double V-shaped high-hardness steel hull of the IM-SHORAD provides high survivability against landmines and improvised explosive devices. It also offers protection against 14.5mm rounds on the frontal arc and all-around protection against 7.62mm ammunition. The vehicle can be fitted with bolt-on ceramic armor packages, which provide all-around protection against 14.5mm armor-piercing ammunition and splinters of 155mm artillery rounds. The IM-SHORAD integrates with existing army networks and is interoperable with Sentinel radar. The vehicle is fitted with radar's multi-mission hemispheric radar. It has four panels on the hull. This active electronically scanned array radar can detect, locate, and track both aerial and surface targets. The IM-SHORAD also has L3 Harris Westcam's MXGCS optical infrared sighting system. It provides the commander with 360-degree aerial surveillance as well as target identification and detection capabilities. As we mentioned earlier, the main armament of the IM-SHORAD is the missiles, not the guns. The passive infrared ultraviolet homing Stinger missiles has a maximum effective range of 4,800 meters and a maximum effective altitude of 3,800 meters. It has a 1 kg high explosive blast smooth case fragmentation warhead with a time delay contact fuse. With a maximum speed of Mach 2.2, the Stinger can be effective against an aerial target, which conducts 8G maneuvers. The total time required for tracking and missile activation is about 6 seconds. When the firing trigger is pulled, the booster of the missile is ignited in only 1.7 seconds. After the Stinger leaves the tube, the booster is jettisoned. Then the Mark 27 solid propellant rocket motor is ignited, the missile reaches the correct acceleration rate in a second, and the M934 time-delayed impact fuse is activated. If it doesn't find a target within 20 seconds, the Stinger distracts itself automatically. The AGM-114L Hellfire Longbow was originally developed for use with AH-64D Longbow Apache helicopters. This fire-and-forget anti-tank missile has a millimeter wave radar seeker. Its maximum effective range is 8,000 meters. The AGM-114L is an anti-tank missile, but thanks to its guidance system and 440 meters per second speed, it is also highly effective against low-flying and low-speed aerial targets. So the main duty of the Hellfire Longbow on the IM-SHORAD is air defense. But the missile's original mission definition also makes the IM-SHORAD a superior anti-tank vehicle. In today's complex combat environment, all kinds of threats can emerge suddenly. and the IM-SHORAD can easily deal not only with aerial vehicles but ground units, including heavily armored main battle tanks. But still, the anti-tank mission is secondary. The 30mm XM914 Bushmaster chain gun of the IM-SHORAD has dual purposes. The first is air defense. To launch a missile against the miniature and mini unmanned aerial vehicles is not economically feasible. Also, their effectiveness against such a small target is low in close distance. But by using programmable air bursting munition, the 30mm gun can effectively deal with them. Also, it is a cheaper solution. This munition can intercept artillery and mortar shells as well as rockets more efficiently. The second purpose of the XM914 is self-defense against ground units. An enemy which is hiding behind the defilade position or inside the trenches is not safe against the programmable air-bursting munition. The 30mm armor-piercing munition is highly effective against armored vehicles. In a complex combat environment, a versatile SPAAG is obviously more advantageous than the conventional ones. But nothing comes without a price. All innovations cause some difficulties at first. The operational use of the anti-tank vehicles and the SPAAGs is different. To use the IM-SHORAD efficiently, the US Army has to update its field manuals. Of course, this is not a big burden, but it takes time. In April 2021, the US Army deployed its first SPAAG to Germany. As the weapon detective, we consider that this deployment is about testing the doctrine as well as the vehicle. These trials would pave the way for determining new field manuals. The multi-role design of the IM-SHORAD increases the workload of its crew, so the training manuals have to be rewritten. The crew has to know when to use the Hellfire or Stinger or when to switch guns precisely. The efficiency of these state-of-the-art weapons is directly related to the training level of the crew. This also takes time. The Stryker was developed to be the main unit of the US Army's Rapid Deployment Force. But in time, it was realized that the vehicle cannot answer some initial criteria, such as the strategic mobility. Also, the survivability of the Stryker was highly criticized during their service in Iraq and Afghanistan. However, we know that the double V-hull variant of the vehicle has overcome the survivability problem. Also, please remember that the IM-SHORAD will accompany the Stryker brigades. So, it does not have to provide strategic mobility higher than personnel carrier or infantry fighting vehicle variants. Besides, considering its dimensions and weight, the IM-SHORAD is the SPAAG which has the highest strategical mobility in the world. If we analyze its international market potential, we can easily see that the turret of the IM-SHORAD has an overly advantageous position. Its modern Western competitors are the Skyranger and Korkut. These two turrets, which are designed for only one mission, are heavy and big. Also, they only have the cannons. Unlike them, the turret of the IM-SHORAD is lightweight, compact, and multifunctional. It can easily be fitted on many modern wheeled and tracked armored vehicles. So, the IM-SHORAD is one of the soundest and most promising military programs of today. It can answer the current complex combat environment, which hides many unexpected threats. The SPAAG can protect the ground troops from unmanned aerial vehicles and loitering munitions. Until the laser weapons emerge, the IM-SHORAD will fill an important gap. Thanks for watching our video. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up if you liked our video. To be notified of our new videos, please click the bell button. Also, you can now click the join button to support our channel.